Well, we've seen problems in other countries. We've seen the fall of Boris Johnson in Britain with no clear successor in sight. There's now going to be a bitter struggle within the Conservative Party to succeed him. And one has to wonder what sort of authority his successor would have. That's another issue. But already we're also starting to see more disputes starting to build. We now have what looks like almost an open quarrel between Germany and Canada about this piece of Siemens equipment, which Siemens unwisely sent to Canada for refurbishment, and which is part of Nord Stream 1, this turbine that is part of Nord Stream 1, and which the Russians say is the reason why they reduced gas flows through Nord Stream 1. Well, the Germans, even Herbert, says that the Canadians should release it. The Canadians said that they wouldn't release it. The Ukrainians are telling the Canadians not to release it. There's now a public row about this. Latest reports suggest that the Ukraine and the Canadians are indeed finally coming round to accepting that they must release it, because otherwise, as Herbert for once said, the sanctions are causing more harm to Germany than they are to Russia. So we'll see what happens. But certainly, across Europe, the gas, the energy sources seem to be getting worse. And to be straightforward about it, I think that even if this gas turbine is returned, we will see them continue to get worse. And we also see that the Ukrainian attempt to stop, to get that Turkish, that Russian ship stopped with all that grain, but that was unsuccessful, as I discussed in my previous program. But perhaps the most interesting thing is that even as the West and Paris seem to be arguing with each other, they all met up together with the other G20 states in Jakarta. The Western powers, in Indonesia I should say, the Western powers, believed the various foreign ministers, refused to interact with Lavrov. They wouldn't even join in the photo session. They tried to get a statement rammed through the G20 critical of Russia, or at least a statement that could be construed as critical of Russia. But the non-Western part of the G20, notably China, India and Brazil, flatly ruled it out. So the result is that the G20 foreign ministers were unable to agree on a joint statement. And in a few, in a little while, we will be seeing the G20 leaders meeting. Putin has been invited. It's not clear whether he's going to actually physically come or whether he's going to address the meeting virtually, but we'll see. But already it's now clear that the Western powers perhaps were hoping again to use the G20 format to win over other countries, non-Western countries, against Russia, and they came up against a brick wall. And I anticipate that this is what's going to continue. So the Western powers, even as they're starting to admit for themselves, far from isolating Russia, what they have instead managed to do is divide the world into camps. The West, and what is increasingly looking like the rest. Now, in that speech which Putin made the other day,